Welcome back. In this video, we will go over the muscles of the upper extremity. Before we start with the muscles, it is very important to imagine the upper extremity in its anatomical position, where the palms are facing forward and the arms are hanging at the sides. So right here, the palms now are facing forward. Based on that, this is the anterior aspect of the upper extremity. And the other side is the posterior aspect. The medial aspect will always be toward the little finger right here. So this entire aspect is the medial aspect. And toward the thumb, we have the lateral aspect. Also, it is very important to know the difference between the arm and the forearm. So right here, where we have the shoulder and the shoulder joint, this is the arm, this is the elbow joint, this is the forearm. We have the wrist joint, and then we have the hand. This is the palm, and the manus is the back of the hand. So let's start with the muscles in the shoulder and the arm region. First, let's identify the bones. We can see here part of the scapula. You can see part of the clavicle right here. Also, right here we can see the spine of the scapula. You can also see the articulation between the acromion and the clavicle right here. Starting with the anterior aspect of the scapula, where we have on the bone the subscapular fossa. This muscle that is on the subscapular fossa is the subscapularis muscle. Okay, moving this to the side, right here we can see the deltoid muscle. This is the deltoid muscle. Let's take the deltoid muscle away. Right here we can see part of the humerus, and this is the spine of the scapula. So the muscle which is located above the spine of the scapula, this is the supraspinatus muscle. So this is the supraspinatus muscle, which is in the supraspinous fossa of the scapula. This muscle right here below the spine of the scapula, the infraspinatus muscle. The infraspinatus muscle is in the infraspinous fossa of the scapula. Moving to this muscle right here, this is the teres minor muscle, and this is the teres major muscle. Now, the subscapularis muscle, which is right here, this is the subscapularis muscle, with the supraspinatus muscle and the infraspinatus muscle and the teres minor muscle, they form the rotator cuff muscles. We can see how they are attached to the head of the humerus, which is this bone right here. So the teres major muscle is not part of the rotator cuff muscles. Moving to this muscle right here, this muscle is the coracobrachialis muscle. Coraco, it's related to the coracoid process of the scapula. So this is the coracobrachialis muscle. Right next to it, we can see the biceps brachii muscle. Biceps means it have two heads. This head right here, which is the lateral head, this is the long head of the biceps brachii, because remember, this is the lateral aspect. That's why it is very important to identify anterior, posterior, medial, and lateral before you start with the muscles. And this is the medial head of the biceps brachii, also called the short head of the biceps brachii. Moving to the muscle next to the biceps brachii, this is the brachialis muscle right here. So let's take this tag right here. This is the brachialis muscle. Moving to the, now we are on the lateral aspect. This muscle is the triceps brachii muscle. Triceps because it has three heads. One, two, and three. That is the third head. So if the upper extremity in the anatomical position, which is that way, we can see right here the medial head of the triceps brachii muscle. The triceps brachii muscle, this is the long head, and this is the medial head of the triceps brachii muscle. Moving to the muscle next to the biceps brachii muscle, this muscle right here is the brachialis muscle. So if we take the biceps brachii muscle away, we can see also the brachialis muscle. Moving lateral, right here we have the triceps brachii muscle. Triceps meaning it has three heads. This is the first head, that is the second head, and this is the third head. So this head is the medial head. Remember, medial head is toward the little finger. That is the medial head. This right here is the long head, and this is the lateral head of the triceps brachii. So let's repeat the muscles while the model on the stand. First, this is the posterior aspect. Right here is the medial aspect of the upper extremity. This is the lateral aspect. And this side, where the palms is facing forward, this is the anterior aspect. So first muscle, which is this muscle right here, this is the subscapularis muscle. We can see part of the teres major muscle right here. This is the clavicle. We can see part of the subclavius muscle. Also, we can see the biceps brachii muscle. So this is the biceps brachii toward the thumb. That is the biceps brachii muscle. That is the deltoid muscle. Let's take the deltoid muscle off so we can see the two heads of the biceps brachii muscle. This right here is the short head, medial head of the biceps brachii muscle, and this is the long head. Okay, moving to the muscle right here, this is the coracobrachialis muscle. Let's turn that to the side. Now we can see the brachialis muscle. And then we have the entire triceps brachii muscle with its three heads. We have the medial head right here. Now the medial head, that is the little finger, that is the medial head, medially. And this is the long head, which runs right under the teres minor muscle right here. We can see the subscapularis muscle, which runs right under the teres minor muscle. And this head is the lateral head of the triceps brachii, which is running toward the thumb. So this is the thumb. It is running toward the thumb. That is the lateral head. This is the long head, and the medial head is right toward the little finger. Let's go over the muscles of the rotator cuff. This is the subscapularis muscle. And right here, we have the supraspinatus muscle. Remember, the model is upside down, so that's the spine of the scapula, the supraspinatus muscle. This is the infraspinatus muscle. That is the teres minor muscle. Those are the rotator cuff muscles. This is the teres major muscle.